The first thing you'll notice once you install ELMS is it doesn't look much like Drupal normally does. So to familiarize yourself with the interface, the top you always have a breadcrumb trail. On the right-hand corner, there's always who you are and a little picture if you'd like to change it. Opening this will give you some additional options. The left-hand menu is where you'll spend most of your time. This changes its options contextually based on where you are in the system. So to get started most quickly, let's create a sandbox. A sandbox is a version of a course that's not connected to a course. You can use this for working on something ahead of when you're done, or just starting up a topic about whatever you want. In here, you'll notice there's section information, but really the only thing that's required is site name. The content template helps to provide instructional design influenced best practices in terms of content structure. We'll make one such outline that's unit-based with 10 lessons as an example. This is also going to be defaulted to an OER section, so this will be available to the public. You can create closed enrolling courses and then have students sign up for them. Now I have my course space registered here. You can see the path has changed. It's hockey class because that's the name of what I've created. And clicking back to the front page will take you to the first page in your content outline. See, hockey class is also up here as a title, and because I selected an outline that's generated with best practices, it populates the pages so that I can get an idea of what a general look and feel might be for my content. Now, because we're in the context of an outline in the course, you can see we have a little widget in the bottom right corner. This is your pagination, as well as some options in terms of being able to print, and if you activate bookmark functionality, bookmarks will show up here. You see, this navigation is very student-centric, and the idea is that this will work on any device without having to move your mouse very much. You can see I'm able to keep the mouse in the same place. Many people have a scroll wheel, so they can actually navigate through the content very efficiently. If you want to edit the page, you'll notice the options on the left have changed. There's the ability to view content, run accessibility tests, edit this content, and if you have developer rights, then you'll see this developer menu. There's also the content outline and version settings, which lets you get into the internals of what is able to be accomplished in this version of a course. If I click edit, you'll see we have a very clean interface for modifying content. Styles, formatting, as well as templates have been influenced heavily based on accessibility requirements and just general stylistic concerns. You can modify anything in the system because it is, at the end of the day, Drupal and CSS and well-documented JavaScript standards. I can go in, I could change my content at this point. See, we have source formatting. We can remove formatting if we want to, add links, images, block quote, all of that. There's also the option to hide this content. Hiding content removes it from display of certain users, in this case, students. So if you would hide something, you'll see it gets crossed out in the outline. And then this way you can continue working on the structure of your course without having the annoyance of possibly having to work on it in a separate location and later move it in. You also notice if you go to pages underneath ones that are hidden, such as this, you'll get a message indicating that this content is not hidden, but its parent is, and so will most likely not be displayed. The last thing I'm going to do in getting started here is, if you click on the site outline, you'll see the outline designer loads. This is a fairly large outline, so it took a little time. You can click through and easily drag and drop content around to reorganize your site structure. Clicking on the edit button with the tools, you'll see additional options you can perform, such as the ability to bulk hide content. You can also add content through this method and delete it. Let's delete unit 1. see a message at the top that says all content was deleted successfully, and then the outline will reload without Unit 1 in it. You can also reorganize individual pieces of content as you see fit, or entire outlines. So we can move Lesson 2 above Lesson 1, and you'll see it's loading. And save. If we go back to the introduction page now, you'll see that the changes made to the outline are immediately reflected in our content outline, as well as some messages about things that have been deleted. For more advanced options, look under version settings, and you can do things such as turn functionality on and off, look at statistics, user management, as well as tweak your theme. Enjoy working with ELMS Beta, and please make sure that you leave any issues in the issue queue on Drupal.org.